let us solve some more problems. Like, you know, in this, a single phase induction motor draws 12 megawatt at 0.6 lag, PF lag. The capacity is connected in parallel to the motor to improve the combined power factor to 0.8 lag. The reactive power delivered by capacitor in MVAR. Basically, this question is like, you know, power factor compensation question. Okay, so the same question can be connected with power systems also. The same question can be connected with synchronous condenser also. Anyway, like, you know, in this, see, here my induction motor is there, single end diagram, okay, and now it is absorbing 12 megawatt at 0.6 lag, okay, such that, as usual, when we discussed about the reactive power long back in the basic concept, immediately after the basic concepts of rotating machines, we said that transmission line current will be more. Now if I can keep one capacitor here, and if this capacitor can supply reactive power such that this particular current can be reduced, magnitude of current can be reduced. Now, because of this capacitor, he is asking the combination should operate now at 0.8 PF lag. How much reactive power it should be given? That's it. Simple. Okay. So let us think of my induction motor is absorbing 12 megawatt at 0.8 lag. So if I draw, for example, this is 12 megawatt. And it is absorbing, no, P plus JQ, VI complex conjugate, or the other side also we can do, not a problem. So this is going to be S. So this is going to be S of induction motor. Okay. So if it is 12 megawatt, the P, how much will be the Q? Q is going to be Q of induction motor. Q of induction motor. So Q of induction motor equal to, okay, means active power is 12 megawatt. So reactive power should be 12 megawatt divided by 0.6 MVA into sine of cos inverse of 0.6. Okay, so you are going to get 16 MVAR. Okay, so this is going to be 16 MVAR in that. Okay, now net, like, you know, this is going to be power factor angle, no? Okay, now in this, the moment I connect capacitor here, my capacitor should supply some reactive power. This is going to be Q of the capacitor, such that my remaining power here, so from here to here, it should operate at a power factor angle of 0.8. So what is required here? What is reactive power still, like, you know, my source has to supply if you calculate. Okay, so this is going to be, how much is this? This is going to be Q of the system. Okay, so Q of the system is going to be how much? Is going to be 12 megawatt by 0.8 into sine of cos inverse of 0.8. Okay, so that much amount of reactive power is still required. So that is going to be 9 kVAR. So this is 9 kVAR. Okay, so the total from here to here is 16. From here to here, it should be 9. So my QC should be 7 MVAR. That much supply should be there from the capacitor. Okay, now let us think of one more question. Actually, this is a beautiful question. Very. Okay, but, like, you know, as it is simplified course, we cannot, like, you know, in detail explain, because some repulsion motor concepts and all will come. Okay, anyway, I will tell you how to remember for sure. Okay, it is nothing actually for you. Now a three-phase slip ring induction motor provided with a commutator winding as shown. Okay, the motor rotates in clockwise direction when the rotor windings are closed. Okay, so let us come to the, what do you say, figure given. So if you observe, okay, so this is prime mover is there, slip ring induction motor is there, the other side, like, you know, commutator is there, one side slip rings are there. Okay, now without prime mover, if I supply three phase supply, my induction motor is rotating in clockwise, he's saying. Okay, now clockwise direction when the rotor windings are closed. Okay, by its own, it's going to rotate in clockwise direction. Okay, so if the motor Okay, so this is slip ring rotor, dear. Slip ring rotor. It is not rotor fed induction motor. Okay, keep that point in mind. If the motor winding is open circuited and the system is made to run, okay, if the rotor winding is open circuited, so rotor voltages may be there, but rotor currents cannot flow. So without rotor currents, how rotor flux will come? No. Okay, so ultimately, in order to have torque develop, stator should supply flux, rotor should supply flux to the air gap. In the air gap, interaction of stator flux and rotor flux will provide you the torque. So once rotor circuit is open circuited, rotor currents cannot flow. Okay, so without rotor currents, rotor flux will not come, interaction will not happen. Okay, so means torque will not be produced in induction motor now. Now, if the motor winding is open circuited and the system is made to run at speed of FR with the help of prime mover in anti-clockwise direction. Okay, now then the frequency of voltage across slip rings is F1, across slip rings is F1, and frequency of voltage across commutator brushes is F2, the values of F1 and F2 they asked. Okay, now let us see, as I told you, repulsion motor concepts are required here. With repulsion motor concepts only you can understand, but do one thing. Okay, for example, let us think of DC motor. Okay, so if I think of DC motor, for example, this is N pole, this is S pole, and this is the commutator. Okay, so this is in the rotor which will have commutator. Okay, now for example, just to remember this, I'm telling you, okay? So in detailed course, I will explain this all together in a different way by considering repulsion motor. For example, these are the field windings, okay? So the moment these are the field windings, now if you supply DC, okay? So if you supply DC to the field windings, and if motor generate whatever it may be, once they are rotating, okay? So internal to the armature, what are the induced voltage, AC or DC? AC. Now that AC will be converted into DC by commutator, okay, in a generator, or in a motor, DC supplied will be converted into AC by commutator. So inside the commutator in the armature, it is AC only, but after commutator, it is DC only, no? Okay, so inside the armature, frequency will be there, but outside the commutator, it will be DC only. So just remember this way: if you supply DC, you will get DC after commutator. If I supply some frequency of FX here after commutator, FX only will have to come. Okay, just remember this because there is no time here. Okay, now next thing is, see here. Prime mover, without prime mover, if I close the slip rings, my induction motor is rotating clockwise. And once you open, rotor currents will not be there, rotor torque will not be there. Now, by keeping prime mover, you are rotating against to that. Okay. So, for example, commutator means that whatever the frequency is happening inside the, rotor, same frequencies will come. So if I supply to stator F1, okay, some frequency stator, and stator MMF is going to rotate in clockwise direction. Okay, now rotor is being rotated in anti-clockwise direction. So for example, stator MMF is rotating in this direction, rotor is rotating in opposite direction, so relative velocity will be doubled. So frequency here, okay, so this is actually input frequency, let me write here. So this frequency is going to be, okay, so because frequency, relative velocity is increased. Now what about the after commutator, frequency will not be changed. Whatever the input frequency you are supplying, the same frequency will come after commutator, independent of direction of rotation or independent of inside frequencies and all, means from DC motor concept, we'll see in the detailed course. So whatever may be the frequency here, same frequency will come. Now let us come back to the question, F1 and F2. Okay, so in F2, for example, F2, whatever may be the frequencies are there, same frequency has to come. So F2 is going to be F only. Okay, so means your rotor may rotate in clockwise direction or anti-clockwise direction with double the speed or triple the speed or independent of that. means my after commutator frequency should be same, like DC DC, just remember that way. So in commutator, across the slip rings, it will be F plus F bar, and in the after the commutator, it will be F only. Okay, so answer should be F plus F bar and F. Okay. In this problem, the figure shows per-phase equivalent circuit of a two-pole, three-phase induction motor operating at 50 Hz. The air gap voltage Vg across magnetizing inductance is 210 volts, and slip is given 0.05. The torque Newton meter produced by the motor is okay. So in this, they have given Vs, they have given Z. Okay, but don't focus on trying to calculate Vs. Because who will produce the torque? Only rotor. Okay, so rotor circuit is given with Vg of 210 volts. Okay, so this particular I2, if I can calculate, okay, so with I2, I2 square R2 by S, M by omega S will give you the torque developed. So let us calculate I2. So how much is I2? 210. Everything is per phase only, no? Divided by how much is this? Slip is going to be 0.05. So this is going to be 1. So 1 square plus 0.22 square under root. Got the current? Okay. Now let us calculate torque developed. It is going to be number of phases in by omega s into I2 square R2 by s is going to be air gap power Pg. Okay. So how many number of phases are there? They have given 3 phase. 3 divided by how much is omega s? 50 Hz two pole means that synchronous speed will be 3000 rpm. So 120 into F by number of poles 2 is going to give you 3000 rpm. Okay, so this is going to be 3000 2 pi n by 60, 2 pi into 3000 by 60 in radians per second into I2 square is going to be this. So I2 square into R2 by S is going to 0.05 by 0.05 is going to be 1. Okay, so this is going to be torque developed. So that torque developed is going to be 401.68 Newton meters. Okay, now let us see the next problem. A 3-phase 4-pole 400 volts 50 Hz squirrel cage induction motor is operating at a slip of 0.02%. The speed of the rotor flux in mechanical radians per second sensed by a stationary observer is closest to. Okay, so first of all, forget about this mechanical radians per second, we will think of later. First of all, where you are sitting, the speed of the rotor flux sensed by stationary observer. In the sense, my rotor MMF, speed of rotor MMF with respect to stator, means that stator MMF, rotor MMF should be stationary with respect to space, okay, with respect to each other, means that with respect to stator, stator MMF rotate by NS. So rotor MMF with respect to stator also should be rotated by NS only. So synchronous speed you have to convert into radians per second. Okay, so what is synchronous speed here? 4 pole 50 Hz. So NS is going to be 120 into frequency 50 divided by 4 is going to be 1500 rpm revolutions per minute. Okay, now 1500 we should not take. Okay, now because it is actually in rpm, he asked in now mechanical radians per second, convert into mechanical, problem solved. So omega s is going to be 2 pi into 2 pi n by 60 is going to give you 157 radians per second. Okay, over. Let us see one more. The starting actually, this problem immediately after the two more problems we'll solve, means everything is related to SC test. I don't understand one thing here. In transformer SC test and in induction motor block rotor test, both are same. Okay, so in transformer series branch parameters will come in SC test, in induction motor series branch parameters will come by block rotor test. Okay, but I don't understand multiple times they are giving these questions, the 2 for 2 marks. Okay, let us see. The starting line current of a 415 volts 3-phase delta connected induction motor, okay, delta connected induction motor is 120 amperes starting line current. Okay, now when the rated voltage is applied to its stator, Okay, the starting line current at reduced voltage of 110 volts in amperes is, okay, point here is one thing. Okay, of course, like, you know, as it is concise course, like, you know, from problems we are trying to derive the concepts. Okay, so point here is why we use starters in induction motor. Okay, of course, in detail course I will tell in detail, but anyway, is line current matters or phase current matters? Okay, for example, at starting, right, starters will be used for starting only, while starting only. So starting torque equal to m by omega s into I starting square into r2 by s is going to be 1. Okay, so starting current in phase or line, phase, because phase currents will produce the torque. So for example, if I have a motor here, induction motor. Okay, so means my starting torque developed in induction motor will be decided by starting currents of phase currents. Okay, so starting torque will be decided by phase currents. But now, frankly speaking, like, you know, keep it in mind in that way only, like, you know, we'll discuss in detail later. Now, like, you know, line currents. Okay, so basically in induction motor, what is happening in induction motor, if you think of this particular circle diagram, okay, so what were the main disadvantages of primitive induction motor? Starting current magnitudes were high and starting power factor was less and starting torques was less. Okay, so for example, if I think of this is S equal to 1, so this is going to be I starting is going to be this. Okay, what is length of current is going to be high at starting, and what is power factor is going to be very less. Okay, so it need huge reactive power. Directly let me connect this to power systems. Okay, so my at starting of my induction motor, it need huge reactive power. So in power systems we know that reactive power and voltage are interlinked. Okay, so the moment it draws huge reactive power means definitely all of a sudden, like, you know, my terminal voltage will be drooped. Okay, source voltage will be drooped. So here, okay, for example, because of currents here in line, huge currents, magnitudes of currents, and, like, you know, huge reactive power requirement is there. Okay, huge demand of reactive power while starting of an induction motor. So because of huge reactive power here, my voltage dip will happen in the source. Okay, so why we use starter in induction motor? Because we have to protect the source. Forget about protecting the motor. Okay, so for my motor, induction motor is so rugged motor. Okay, nothing will happen to the induction motor, but my source voltage dip will happen because of huge demand of reactive power. In power systems, already you might know reactive power and voltage profile are interlinked. Okay, so always in starters, like, you know, you have to focus on whether they are focusing on starting torque of induction motor, then phase currents has to be taken. If they ask, like, you know, line currents, means that they are focusing on the dip in the source voltage. Now let us come back. Now let us see, like, you know, they said line currents. Okay, so this line current, for example, this is connected in delta, my induction motor is connected in delta. So in delta, at starting, this is 120 amperes line current. Okay, so, like, you know, don't try to add divided by root 3 into root 3 here, because if phase current is going to be 120 by root 3, anyway, this is going to be 120. Okay, for a voltage of 415 volts at starting. Now, for example, if I reduce this voltage to 110 volts, this current has to be reduced or not? Yes. So logic here is, once it is under starting conditions, what is the speed of the rotor? Zero. Blocked rotor test. Okay, so in blocked rotor test also, what was happening? I was stopping the rotor not to rotate. Okay, so blocked rotor test means that S equal to 1. Now in starters also, S equal to 1 only. So blocked rotor test can be directly connected with the starters. Okay, so in blocked rotor test, what was happening means, by blocked rotor test, you are going to get series branch parameters which are linear as per transformers. Okay, so for example, if I have any linear parameters, Okay, so if voltage is 415 volts, I got current of 120 amperes. If voltage is reduced, automatically current will be reduced in the same proportion. In the same proportion, because network is linear, because block or rotor test, because series branch parameters. Okay, so how much is the current now? This current means once it is reduced, it is going to be 120 should be reduced or increased. Voltage is reduced, so it should be reduced. So 110 should be in the numerator, 415 should be in the denominator. Okay, so we are going to get a current of 31.807. This is going to be 31.807 amperes of current we'll get in line. Okay, because in phase, if it is reduced by same percentage, in line also it will be reduced by same percentage. Okay, in this section let us see star connected 12.5 kilowatt 208 volts line, three phase 60 hertz. Normally we are habituated with 50 hertz, so make a note, 60 hertz. Squirrel cage induction motor has the following equivalent circuit parameters per phase referred to stator. What are those? R1 value they have given, R2, X1, X2 referred to stator. The starting current in amperes for this motor when connected to an 80 volts line, 20 hertz 3 phase AC supply is. Okay, so point here is, like, you know, whether they asked line current or phase current. Okay, basically in order to protect the source in induction motor, line current matters. Okay, and in order to think of starting torque produced by the motor, so, like, you know, in phase currents are important. Okay, so for example, here he said star connected, and the starting current in amperes for this motor when connected to an 80 volts and 20 hertz 3 phase. Okay, so the starting currents in amperes for this motor, means that we have to think of motor currents only, in the sense per phase currents only. But anyway, like, you know, he reduced frequency from 60 hertz to 20 hertz, so reactance values will be reduced. So for example, this is R1, X1 and X2, R2 by S. Okay, so this is going to be R1, this is X1, this is X2, of course J terms will come. Okay, and this is R2 by S is 1, because it's starting. Okay, now how much voltage he want to supply here? 80 volts. And star connected per phase 80 divided by root 3. Okay, now if you think of, like, you know, you have to calculate current, that's it. Per phase only, because they ask for motor. Okay, so how much is current here? 80 divided by root 3 by Z. In that Z, X1 and X2 for 60 hertz, I know the value is 0.41. So it will be for 20 hertz, it should be reduced. So in this case, X1 dash equal to X2 dash equal to 0.41 into divided by 60 into 20. It is the reduction, because frequency is reduced, it has to be reduced. So calculate this current. So this current equal to 80 by root 3 divided by R1 R2 0.3 0.6 square plus X1 and X2. So 2 into 0.41 into 20 by 60 square under root. Okay, so this value is going to be roughly 70.05 amperes, or we can say this is 70.1 ampere. Let us think of second question. Okay, next question. A delta connected 3.7 kilowatt 400 volts line, 3 phase 4 pole 58 squirrel cage induction motor has following equivalent circuit parameters referred to stator per phase. As usual, R1, R2, X1, X2. The starting line currents in amperes, see here, the starting line currents, in the sense he is most focused on the source now, not on the motor. Line current in amperes when connected to a 100 volts 10 hertz. Okay, so this is delta connected. Now line current will be root 3 times phase current. Okay, so it is 100 volts 10 hertz. Okay, so for 50 hertz, I got X1 and X2 as 8.22. So if I think of, like, you know, for 10 hertz, it will be 1 by 5. So in this case, X1 dash equal to X2 dash equal to 8.22 into 50 to 10, it should be reduced. So 10 by 50. Okay, now let us think of, like, you know, phase currents here. Okay, directly if I think of phase current, so R1, X1, X2, R2, R2 by S is going to be 1 only. Okay, so how much is R1? 5.39. And how much is R2? 5.72. And how much is X1 and X2? 8.22 into 10 by 5 or 8.22 by 5. Okay, 8.22 by 5, 8.225 by 5. How much is this? This is going to be 100. Delta connected 100 volts line is nothing but phase voltage, so 100 volts. Okay, so how much is this current? 100 divided by 5.39. For example, this current, if I think of IP, so IP equal to 100 divided by 5.39, because resistance will not change depending upon frequency, 5.72 square plus x1 dash plus x2 dash square under root. Okay, into what is line current now? Line current in the, what is it, delta connected is going to be root 3 times phase current. Okay, so root 3 into use this, so that way it will be 14.9486 amperes, or roughly we can say 15 amperes.